was destroyed, and he got permission to go and start building this city for him.
Amen.
Even for the king was in on it. I'll give the letter. You take the letter to the king, and this letter will grant you whatever you need. All the wood to build whatever you need.
Praise the Lord.
And it pleased the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
When we do something like this, it pleases the Lord. If we are together to build His kingdom up, it pleases the Lord. When people stand and praise God and honor with the mission, words to hear His word, it pleases God.
Amen.
They confess the sins of their fathers. And they repented of their sins. What a revival started in the Old Testament. They had it going on, didn't they? They could hear from God. They got answers from God. They got the permission from God to go on. The letter was granted. People repented of their sins. Even them, I said, we transgressed against the law. We sinned against even the law of Moses. We have sinned. And God granted everything they asked. Well, wouldn't that be one? You
could, praise the Lord.
Do you wonder if that could happen in the New Testament church?
Come on, man.
What would happen in the New Testament church? Brother Porter, that was in the Old Testament.
Thank you, Jesus.
Testament church is.
Praise the Lord.
I want you to turn over with me to the book of Acts.
Thank you, Jesus. 3. Praise the Lord.
Verse 37. I'm going to read some verses here. Acts chapter 2, verses 37. And I'm going to read down to verse 46, 47. Is that possible today? God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, isn't He?
Amen.
What He done back in the old, I got an idea He's going to do it in the new.
Amen.
Acts chapter 2, beginning with verse 37. Peter, you're preaching the day of Pentecost. Verse 27. Now when they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? That is the question we need to ask for God. What shall we do? Just like Nehemiah talked to God and got permission. Then Peter said unto them in verse 38, repent. Is that what he did? Under Ezra. So what they did was,
amen,
they repented because they heard the word of God.
Yes.
Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, for remissions of sins, for you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise to you and your children, all throughout as many as the Lord God, whom He shall call. And with many other words, and they testify and exhort, said, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Save yourself. Don't get swallowed up in this sin. Verse 41. Then they that gladly received this word were baptized. And the same day they were added unto them about 3,000 souls.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
3,000 souls. And Brother Carter, you don't believe that's going to happen. I believe that will happen just
tonight. Yes, it could.
As it happened.
Praise the Lord.
God said before Abraham was
Jesus.
Zion, God is the same yesterday. God is the same today.
Praise the Lord.
He's
hallelujah.
The kingdom of God was built up.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's been built up today, my friend.
Praise the Lord.
God hasn't changed.
That's right.
His word hasn't changed. The gospel hasn't changed. Anybody changed, it's us.
Yeah. Come on, preacher.
Repentance.
Forgive us, Lord.
Happened in Nehemiah and Ezra. They confessed. Here, they asked Peter, what must we do? Peter said, repent. Save yourself from this untoward generation. They gladly received it, verse 41. The same words added 3.